Good evening, everyone. Thank you so much for joining the meeting and taking time to join the meeting for Sendira Ranch and Diamondback Lane Traffic Signal Project. So just to avoid echo and disturbance during the meeting, I would request everyone to be on mute. Here is the mute symbol to mute yourself. And if you have any questions during the meeting, please ask them in the chat box, and once we are done with the presentation, I'll answer all the questions in the chat box. So this is a community meeting for traffic signal project at Sendira Ranch and Diamondback Lane. And I'm Shweta Rao. Sorry for not introducing myself earlier. I'm Shweta Rao. I'm the project manager for this project, and we have with us a team of members from the city and our engineer. So we have Lisette Acevedo. She's the program manager over mobility infrastructure group. We have Jeff Allen. He's our communication specialist. He's the one who facilitates all these meetings. We have with us Ganesh Gopalan. He is our engineer on this project from IEA Engineering. And we have with us Aziz from transportation management team. They are the one who generally do all the study and prioritize the project for our group. So this is the brief agenda of the presentation. I'll be going over the project background and provide a project update and go over the project schedule and provide the contact information for the city as well as the contractor. So coming to the project background, this project was prioritized by transportation management in 2019 for a traffic signal. So a study was done and the traffic counts were gathered, and a study was done to prioritize the traffic signal at this location. So the objective of this project is generally to improve the traffic flow during the peak hours and also improve the safety for pedestrians at the intersection. So we have a elementary school very close to this intersection, and I think we have some daycares and other businesses that attract pedestrians. So it's very important to provide a pedestrian safety at such locations. So we will be installing pedestrian traffic signals with push buttons that would facilitate a safer crossing for the pedestrians. And we will also be installing pedestrian access elements like sidewalks and curb ramps, ADA accessible, ADA compliant curb ramps at this location. This project is funded by transportation impact fees, and it's funded using 2019 funds. So this is the project location that we're talking about. It's currently an always stop controlled intersection. So it's closer to the Sendira Ranch Elementary. We have a CVS here, and just a few businesses over here. We had a design phase public meeting for this project in January of 2020, where 14 residents attended the meeting, and we sent out almost 317 mailers. So there were a few concerns during this meeting, and I just want to go through the one, some of the highlights of the questions that we received during that meeting. So the first one is, why is a traffic signal suggested for this location? So as I said earlier, there was a traffic study that was done to check if the location warrants a signal. And it was recommended, this location was recommended because of the delays that were caused during peak hours, and also to improve the safety for the pedestrians. So like I said, the traffic signal is warranted by a traffic signal warrant study. So the second question that we received was, traffic congestion is a temporary issue at this location. Why is city proposing a permanent solution? So the traffic congestion might be a temporary issue currently, but with the future prediction, the traffic volumes are going to increase quite a bit over the next few years, and that might cause more delays, and it would make the intersection more unsafe for the pedestrians. So considering when the traffic study was done, the current traffic counts itself met the signal warrants. So this location was prioritized considering its proximity to the elementary school and considering the increase in the traffic volumes over the year, it would have made the intersection much unsafe for the pedestrians. And so a traffic signal would provide predictable gaps for the students or the pedestrians to cross at the intersection. And this will also eliminate speeding issues. Currently, the last time when we were there, we had some residents complaining about people speeding through there, not stopping at the stop sign. So this would probably eliminate that issue too. The next question that we received was, will the hump on Diamondback Lane be addressed? So those who know this intersection really well, there's a bit of a hump on the east leg of the intersection on Diamondback Lane. And that was an issue that was raised during the meeting if that hump could be addressed as a part of this project. So our team, the city team with the engineer, met on site and went over the engineering that needed to be done to remove that hump. So it was found that we would have to redo quite a bit of, we would have to redo the street again to eliminate that hump, and we would also require a lot of drainage improvements to maintain the water flow and everything. So that would have been a more expensive affair for this project. A request was sent to Transportation Management Department to consider this issue for the future projects whenever the street needs to be redone. So signal warrant, the last time we had the public meeting, we had questions about signal warrants, and we didn't have details on it in our last public meeting presentation. But the traffic signal study that was done earlier was an old study. So we just redid the traffic counts again in February of 2020 after our public meeting in January. So we collected a 24-hour traffic count, and then we measured the traffic counts against the signal warrants specified in Texas Manual of Uniform Traffic Control Devices, MUTCD. It has different types of study, and it has 9 different variations in which a location could meet a signal warrant. And if a location meets more than 1 or 2 signal warrants, then a location can be a location is eligible to have a traffic signal. So the 24-hour counts included the turning movements, the traffic volumes going through the intersection, and also the pedestrian counts. So here is the list of 9 warrants specified in MUTCD. So there are different kinds of warrants, like 8-hour vehicular volume, 4-hour vehicular volume, peak hour, roadway network, crash experience, school crossings. So when we did the traffic volume study, the volume is counted per hour, and it's measured against these warrants to see if the location, the traffic volume at the location meets these warrants. So for a 4-hour vehicular volume, this location met 2 warrants, the 4-hour vehicular volume and the peak hour warrant. So the 4-hour vehicular volume states that if the hourly volume for any 4 hours on an average day on a major street meets the corresponding hourly traffic volume on the minor street. So there's a graph, I'll be showing it in the next slide. I'll explain it further in the next slide. So this is warrant 2, that's a 4-hour vehicular volume. So it shows different volumes on a major street, and then it shows corresponding volumes on the minor street. So for a specific traffic volume on a major street, we should have the volume on the minor street more than what's shown on this graph. So if we have that for any 4 hours during the day, this warrant is met. And we had traffic volumes on the minor street more than what's shown on this graph, but corresponding volumes on major street. So this 4-hour vehicular volume signal warrant was met for this location. Similarly, the next warrant is the PCAR volume warrant. So what this warrant states is that for any 4 consecutive 15-minute intervals, the traffic on the major street and the traffic on the minor street combined should be higher than what's shown on the graph. So we met this warrant too, because we had the traffic on the major and the minor street more than what's shown on this graph for 4 consecutive 15-minute intervals. That's called the PCAR. 4 15-minute intervals equals 1 hour. Coming to the project schedule, we are currently in bid and award phase. So we are currently executing the contract with our contractor for construction. And in parallel, we are also acquiring some temporary construction easements at the intersection on the corner clips that would facilitate us to perform construction and store construction material. And we are estimating the right of acquisition to complete by January of 2021. And we are also waiting on utility relocation from Encore. We have some poles on the west side of the intersection, Encore poles that needs to be relocated. So for us to install the traffic signal, so we are kind of waiting on them to relocate the poles before starting construction. And we anticipate the relocation to be done around the same timeline, January of 2021. The next thing is the contract execution for the construction. Just like I said, we are currently executing the contract with the contractor, and we estimate that to be completed in winter of 2020-2021. And we estimate the start of construction by late winter or early spring of 2021. The construction duration is around 8 months, and it's 8 months because we have quite a bit of lead time on procuring the signal poles. And if we receive the signal poles earlier, that might even reduce the construction duration, but it's the conservative duration of 8 months considering delays caused by procuring delays in procuring the traffic signal poles. The estimated cost of construction for the traffic signal is $450,000. This is the contact information for our contractor as well as the city project manager. So our contractor is Bean Electrical, and we have contact information for Cody Turner, who is the superintendent for Bean Electrical, and they'll be handling the construction for this project. And I will be the project manager, and there's my phone number and my email ID if you have any questions during or before construction. That is all I have. Let me know if you have any questions.
I see Rosalinda raising her hand. Jeff, can you unmute her? Jeff?
Working on it. Everybody should be able to unmute.
Okay. Rosalinda, can you unmute?
Yes. So I have a question. So the traffic study was that the one where we all met at a school like last year? Is that this project that we're talking about? When was the traffic study done? Let me just ask.
So we had a traffic study done earlier that was old, but we did it again in February of 2020 to make sure that we have the most recent traffic count.
Okay. And then you also had a map showing where the improvements were going to occur. Can I get a copy of that? Can I get a copy of that?
Yeah, sure. The map, this map?
That one. Okay. So that's gonna occur right there at the CVS?
Yes.
Okay. Oh, perfect. And the hump that y'all are talking about removing?
So no, we won't be removing the hump as a part of this project, but we have submitted a request to transportation management. So if they have any projects in the vicinity, they could come and address that issue.
Would it be possible for me to ask for a copy of this presentation?
Sure. This presentation will be posted on our city website. But I could share it with you too.
Please. I just want to keep that map on because I know I'm going to have some people because I sent this notice out on Nextdoor for them to partake, and I know they're going to have some questions. So it's got your information on there.
Okay. So if you could just email me on my email ID that was shown on the last slide, let me pull that up. And I could share the presentation with you.
Yes. Thank you.
Welcome. Do we have any other questions?
And y'all are going to do the traffic light? Y'all aren't going to do a traffic circle?
No, it won't be a traffic circle. It would be a traffic signal.
That would be nice.
I think that the reason for not considering reconstruction of for the roundabout is because the roundabout is quite cost prohibitive. Roundabouts are running almost $3 million and it will require a lot more considerable right away. And we have, you know, the CBS at a corner and I think a daycare on another corner. So the traffic signal provides the best alternative with the funding that we have available for this intersection.
Thank you, Lizeth.
I saw a question on the chat box, Shweta.
Yeah, I think that's a very good idea for all the homeowners to see, because that's exactly where I was going to send this to the Sendero Ranch HOA.
Oh, Shweta, can you see the question there? I can.
No, I cannot. Okay.
It says, can you supply the slides to the HOA management company so that they could post for all homeowners to see?
Sure. Me and Jeff will try to reach out to the HOA and share the presentation with them.
Thank you, Shaquille.
Okay. Do we have any more questions?
I think that concludes our presentation, Shweta.
Okay, thank you all for joining the presentation today. And we'll be sharing the presentation with the HOA and I mean, if someone emails me, I'll be glad to share the presentation with them too. And thank you all, have a good evening.
Thank you.